eat healthy, Dad.
Healthy isn't enough. If you're going to take home that trophy, you need to eat what winners eat. Remember, second place is the first loser. Come on, fuel up session. Let's feed the tiger. Emily, we're going to take breakfast now. Get ready.
Ah! Ah!
Okay, now that you're full of rocket fuel, take a half hour to rest and meet me on the course.
Your dad's pretty excited about the state slalom championship.
You think it was him competing in the stupid race?
You don't much like racing, do you?
You won't say anything to my dad?
No, of course not.
I hate it. All of it. I hate the hours, the stupid diets. I hate my dad being coach all the time. I just want it to be over, but at the same time, I'm scared. What if I lose? My bricks are too thin.
For indoor use, certainly. This fireplace has fire hazard written all over it.
Is that all?
The city is prepared to make you a generous offer.
This is half of what we paid for it.
Which is still quite a bit more than zero, Mr. O'Malley. Which is exactly what you'll get if this wreck is permanently condemned. Even if it's not, the voters will see the wisdom in my road expansion measure. Take the money, Mr. O'Malley. You can't win here.
This restaurant, this house, will be perfect before the deadline. And as you noted earlier, Councilwoman, elections are right around the corner. Oh man, what did I just do?
Thank you.
Emily, have you seen Marisa?
Not since yesterday. Why?
She's been missing since after dinner last night. No text, no phone call.
I'm sure she's just blowing off steam or something. You know teenagers.
No. She's missed 2 training sessions. That's not like her at all.
I'll keep an eye out for her. Okay?
I'll search the slopes. Thank you. Nothing. My employees just told me they had a small avalanche late last night. The course was closed to the public, but Marisa and I trained there a lot.
I'm sure she wasn't there.
How can you be so sure? Marisa's very focused on winning that race. We're going to search the slope, just in case.
I'll come with you.
No. You'd better stay here in case she turns up. Call me on the radio if you see her.
Of course.
Thank you.
Marisa? Your father is going out of his mind with worry. You won't tell him I'm here, will you?
Marisa, I was worried sick. Where were you?
I... You can tell him, Marisa.
I don't want to race. But we've been training for this all year.
I know, Dad. It's just... I could tell you wanted this so bad. I didn't want to hurt your feelings. But you're so focused on me winning first place. I can't deal with the pressure.
Marisa, I'm sorry. I just wanted you to feel confident in yourself. Like you could do anything, you know? Don't worry about the race, okay? It's not what's most important.
What's going on, hon?
Patrick, you've been working so hard. And I know you want everything to be just perfect. But even this house isn't worth losing our sanity over.
We may not be the best craftsmen, but we're here to help, Patrick.
Yes, we are. Well, could someone give me a hand with this scaffolding?
Paige?
Thank you.
Perfect, huh? Let's see how you like breaking an arm when you can least afford it.
Thank you.
So you competed after all.
Yeah, well, I did train pretty hard for it. Plus, once my dad chilled out, it was pretty fun.
She raced her heart out and got third place. I've never been so proud. Why don't you get us some celebratory desserts? I want to thank you for being there for Marisa.
I'm just glad it all worked out.
Anyhow, she's retiring. No more competitive skiing.
What about you?
I'm going to Moonlight as a private coach to pay for all that ski gear I bought.
Thank you.
I should really keep working on the chimney.
Final inspection isn't until tomorrow. Let's get through this meeting first.
Boo!
Good evening, everyone. I'm Councilwoman Stepford, sponsor of Measure 21. Thank you for attending today's on-site community meeting. I've already heard from many of you. I assure you, I take your feedback very seriously. But Snugford Hills is growing. Freeway access isn't a luxury but a necessity. The neighborhood needs better access to emergency services. And businesses here are suffering.
Businesses? What about my business?
This house is a danger to the public. My own daughter suffered a terrible injury here.
It was an accident. Mommy being mean. Grace is my friend. We ran away. Girls, come down right now!
Wait, stop! I threw away some of the bolts last night. It won't bear any more weight. It'll fall apart.
Everyone, grab hold!
My baby!
Where do you think you're going, kitten cake?
This chimney is still a fire hazard.
Yeah, well, your boss had a little something to do with that.
I'm sorry, Mr. and Mrs. O'Malley, but you are out of time.
Martin?
Yes, Councilwoman.
Buzz off.
Here to reschedule the meeting?
There'll be no more meetings. And no more inspections. The house is no longer condemned.
What I did to the scaffolding, it's inexcusable.
You could have seriously hurt someone, Sharon.
My little princess, I was so angry.
And for what? A spoiled pageant season she doesn't even enjoy.
Good luck with your restaurant, Emily. You deserve it.
The curtains were a little drab anyhow, weren't they? Look at our house. It's perfect, Patrick. My dad put up the lights, didn't he?
Yep.